I want to reckon my heartfelt thanks to LUGI for giving this wonderful opportunity to introduce Mr. Hariharan Iyer. Hariharan Iyer is a multifaceted personality and combines various talents with the intent of making a difference to people's lives. He left a well-paying corporate job to pursue his vision of reaching out to a large number of people and creating a world-class training organization. His last corporate job was with New York Life Insurance as a general training head, in which role he was managing over 100 trainers. He is a founder of Hariharan School of Success Education and is properly referred to as the entertainer due to his entertaining style of speaking and training. He is an accomplished and passionate motivational speaker with over 25 years of training experience. He has delivered sessions in over 50 cities in India, as also in Dubai and Nepal. Hariharan is also a Reiki grandmaster, practicing the spiritual healing science for over 21 years. He has been in teaching Reiki for over 16 years. Hariharan is also an author of 3 books. First one, Honey, I Love Money, Success and You, Life-Changing Principles for Health, Happiness and Prosperity. Second, He Sold It, I Did Not Buy It, 21 Priceless Commandments of Effective Selling. Third, Dear Diksha, Father's Letter to His Teenage Daughter, published by Krima Books. Hariharan has a multi-industry experience in conducting programs and doing consulting, coaching assignments for the well-known companies like Rolls-Royce, LAC, SBI Life Insurance, Kotak Life Insurance, ICICI Bank, Landmark Pharmaceuticals, Cipla, Murugappa Group, and IndiaMart. Few programs that Hariharan has conducted over the years include leadership skills, selling skills, communication skill, stress management, conflict management, team building, and change management. Besides corporates, Hariharan also conducts sessions for students and teachers. Hariharan is a recipient of Rex Karmavir Global Fellowship and Karmavir Chakra Bronze and Silver Awards, instituted by I Can't Go in recognition of making a difference to people's life through his work. More of his details are obtained in his website, www.livetransmission.in. Right now, I invite Mr. Hariharan Iyer to grace the dais.
We also call upon Ms. R. Rukmini from the KG Road branch, Bangalore, to hand over the bouquet to Shri Hariharan Iyer. We invite Ms. R. Rukmini from the KG Road branch, Bangalore.
Namaskaram. Thank you so much. Ninga already enak standing ovation kuduthutel, so the session has already gone off very well. Thank you so much. It is such an honor to be here, and it is such a privilege to be back in Kerala in this kind of a conference in front of such amazing people. And I really thank you for the invitation.
There is nothing you cannot achieve. No skill you cannot master. Flesh and bone.
So let's have a big round of applause for all you awesome people who do one of the most difficult things in the world, which is sell life insurance or any kind of insurance. So this is the last session of the evening, so I'm reminded of one Rajinikanth dialogue which says, "La leta vandalu latesta varve." Right? So yeah, and Rajinikanth is one of the most awesome superstars this world has ever seen, is one of the greatest inspirations that we have. So I think what I request all of you is, at least some of you watch Hindi films, or all of you watch Hindi films? Yeah, so there is one beautiful movie which came many years ago, which is called as Munna by MBBS. And there is one particular statement which became very popular because of that film, which is called as Jadu Ki Jhappi, which is basically giving a hug to each other to celebrate our success. So when I say 1, 2, 3, go, I would request each one of you to please stand up and give a Jadu Ki Jhappi to the person to your right and to your left. Only disclaimer is, if there is a lady to your right or left, please do a namaskaram. Okay, so can I request all of you to please stand up and do a Jadu Ki Jhappi? 1, 2, 3, go. Yeah, two ladies can hug each other. I think all of you also deserve a Jadu Ki Jhappi from each other. Well done, well done. Wow, how is the feeling? Very good, very good. Srinivasan sir is getting one free massage also. So there is a foot massage outside and a shoulder massage is also available inside. Excellent. So it's a great feeling to be back in Kerala, because I used to work here for Max New York Life about 7-8 years ago as a regional training head, and I've traveled every part of Kerala, many parts of Kerala, and in fact I used to stay in Edappally. So it is fantastic to be back in Edappally to be doing this little session for all of you. Let's have some power going today. I have a lot of respect for agent advisors from whichever company they come from, it doesn't matter, because you do one of the most awesome jobs in this world, which is to go out of your comfort zone, meet different kinds of people every day, and sell one of the most difficult products in the world, which is called insurance, right? And I think you guys are doing such an awesome job. I get inspired. So people call me an inspirational speaker, but actually I am just a student, and I inspire people not because I want to inspire you, but actually I want to get inspired. So whenever I come and talk to people, it is a great inspiration for me, and I don't consider myself a trainer or a speaker. I really consider myself to be just a student of life. And one of the best things about my profession is, if I have to teach something to someone, I have to learn every single day. I sat through the morning session and there was this amazing input which was given by Mr. Dushyant, which he said that, please preach what you practice. And I think that's a life-changing context. It is a life-changing statement, and I'm going to use it somewhere, because we all trainers try to take something from here, something from there, and pass it on for the larger benefit of the world. There is another great speaker that I know, and maybe some of you also know, from Malaysia, Mr. SK Sammy, and I think he's been on the LUGI platform before, and I really believe that it is Sammy sir's blessings, Arvind Mani sir's efforts, and all the efforts of the organizers which has got me to this amazing platform. And Sammy sir once made a statement in Nagpur when I was attending a session, and I was also a faculty there. He said, money is not everything. This is what we learnt in school, right? We were taught money is not everything, but he completed the sentence by saying, everything is money. While money is not everything, but everything is money. And sometimes in life, our understanding is only up to the comma, and we think it is a full stop. The sentence is not complete. And when somebody comes and tells you something like, only preach what you practice, or if somebody says money is not everything but everything is money, I don't remember anything else from that session. I remember only that one statement, and that changed my life. And even when I wrote a book for my daughter when she turned 16 years 2 years ago, I mentioned this statement in this book so that my daughter remembers it. So I hope that when you're undergoing a lot of sessions, we will be talking 25 things. You know, because you have to speak for 1.5 hours. Money, Arvind Mani sir clearly told me, you get your payment if you speak 1.5 hours. Right? So in 1.5 hours, I'm going to speak maybe 25, 30 things. But if you can take just one thing from this session, which can change your life, I think I would have done my job and you would have got your money's worth and your time's worth. So I really hope that this is going to be one more of that session, which is going to help you to take that one thing out of this session, which can help you become a better professional, a better human being, a better father, a better mother, a better citizen of this country. And we are going through what is now called as the VUCA world. Any idea what is a VUCA world? This is a dream come true to see myself on the screen. So, what is a VUCA world? A VUCA world is volatility, uncertainty, complexity, and ambiguity. We live in a world where nobody wants a president to be like Donald Trump, but he becomes the president. Nobody wants to give up his 500 rupee and 1000 rupee notes, but that is gone forever. Nobody wants to come out of their comfort zone, but everybody is forced to be out of their comfort zone. And nobody in this world ever thought that the Tatas will have a mudslinging match in the middle of a board meeting or in front of the media, in front of the whole country. That is how the world is changing today. Whatever you thought was the perfect belief is no longer a belief. And whatever you thought is the right way of working, that working has completely become irrelevant. What Mr. Dushyant was talking about is the whole idea of relevance today is getting questioned. So we live in this VUCA world, which is volatility, uncertainty, complexity, and ambiguity. So my session, which is going to talk about the 10 power performance parameters, hopefully will try and help you to somewhere address this VUCA problem in our country. And I'm sure that all of you are very successful advisors and you've been selling insurance for a very long time. But I'm sure that what was the scenario 10 years ago is not the scenario today. Am I right? What was the scenario 1 year ago is not the scenario today. And trust me, whatever is the scenario today will not be the scenario tomorrow. That's how quickly this whole world is changing today. And I always tell audiences, why do you invite me as a motivational speaker? Because 125 crore Indians are motivational speakers today because of WhatsApp. Every day, 6 o'clock in the morning, you get one motivational message, and that same message goes through 4 different groups with minor verifications or variations. Until 12 o'clock in the night, you are so motivated, so motivated, so motivated that you are tired and you want to go to sleep. You know, so that motivation doesn't actually help you to work. So, and that is just forward messages. So, I think the problem today is that we have a lot of content, but we don't have any perspective. You know, we have a lot of content, but we don't know what we know, and we don't know what we should not know. And whatever we know, we don't know what to do with that. So what will I do with 25 or 50 motivational messages in the day? What India needs today is not motivation. What India needs today is the right attitude. You know, and I always tell people that knowledge is not power anymore. It is one of the most useless things in the world. Intelligence, knowledge, talent. We all grew up in the older India, you know, 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s. And we were told intelligence is a very big thing. I still don't have the courage to take an intelligence quotient test, IQ test. I did not clear it in school. I'm unlikely to clear it now. So it's, intelligence is not very important, but attitude is very, very important. So this whole 10 performance, power performance parameters is really about the attitude with which we should be working and we should be selling whatever we are selling in our life. So I have 3 important questions for all of you. First of all, are you happy with your life? I wanted to ask yourself this question. Are you happy?
Yes.
Why are you happy?
Because
there is going to be a DJ party at 8 o'clock. There's going to be drinks at 7 o'clock. And there's going to be amazing dinner at 9 o'clock. Right? Is that the reason why you're happy? I'm sure you're not there for that. That's just an add-on. But my question is, why are you happy? And what I expect as an answer is, I am happy because I don't have any reason to be happy. I am happy just for being happy. A lot of people are searching for happiness through their success. But my point of view here is, and this is a little research that I've done with all the successful people in the world, they became successful because they are happy. So your happiness does not come from your success. Your success comes from your happiness. So whatever the situation in life, you should be happy. Yes, that doesn't mean that you will not feel sad, or you will not have problems, you will not have challenges, you will not cry, you will not have fears, you will not have uncertainties, you will not have struggle. Despite all that, the core nature of a human being is that is ananda. We all need to be happy because that's the biggest success in the world. Because now, what happened 2 days ago, with 500,000 rupee notes getting thrown out of the window, a lot of people who had crores of rupees, who were happy 72 hours ago, are extremely sad now, because the reason for their happiness was money. And today there is a joke which is going around in the WhatsApp world that children with piggy banks are now lending money to their parents. So you take it, you know, and they are more happy than anyone. And I love children, especially today's generation, because they are so happy and parents don't like their happiness. So parents are saying, we were never so happy. Our parents never, because we were trained in a very different way. Saapdum bodhu paisa koodadhu. Loudly paisa koodadhu. Bathroom la paada koodadhu. A.R. Rahman is not giving me a chance to be a playback singer. Where else will I sing? I have to sing in the bathroom, right? So I want all of you to be happy from today for no reason. There are thousands of reasons to be sad about. The Kochi climate, airport, roads, corruption, politicians, mother-in-law, father-in-law, wife, husband. There are so many reasons to feel sad, but you don't need any reason to be You don't need reason to be happy in life. The second question that I have for all of you is, are you hungry? And here I mean hunger for success. Now, please understand there are two different things. You may be happy, you may not necessarily be very successful. You may be successful, but you may not be really happy. If you ask me between both, which is more important, I would say first learn to be happy. You will find a way to be successful. But if you're going to link your happiness to your success, then only sorrow is going to follow you all the time. Because how many of you are MDRT agents here? Excellent. So when you became an MDRT for the first time, how many hours the joy of becoming an MDRT lasted? 24 hours? 48 hours? 72 hours. The tragedy was, the moment you were declared an MDRT and your development officer saw you, he said, now your next year's MDRT work starts now. So all your success of becoming an MDRT evaporated in 72 hours. But that feeling of becoming an MDRT remains with you all your life. So what is more important? It's success or happiness. It's always happiness. But if you want to be successful, and success is very important in life, not for anything, but just to get a kick out of life. You need some reason to exist, right? You need some excitement in life. So for that, you need to be successful. And for that, you need to be hungry. When do you enjoy your food the most? When do you enjoy your food the most? When do you enjoy drinking water the most? When you're thirsty, right? So when will you enjoy working the most? When you are hungry and you're thirsty to go on the field and try and sell the next policy. And I always believe in one thing, that life begins at 40. And there is a reason for this. There is a scientific reason for this. First 20 years is all time pass. You don't know what happened to you. You grew up, life was good, everybody took care of you. And the next 20 years is full of tragedies and challenges. What is the first challenge that you face? Job and? So I have asked thousands of people this question. All of them have said marriage. Still they are in a hurry to get their children married. So that's when I realized that parents understand that they should not allow their children also to be happy. Right? So in the period 21 to 40, you go through a lot of confusion in life. Lot of challenges. You don't know which career to take. What should I do? You know, what will happen? Then you get married. You have children. You are worried about the responsibility. It's only after 40 when you start realizing it's tea break. It's lunch break. Half the test match is over. Now only half the test match is remaining. What have I done so far with my life? And you will see all great people, most of them achieved greatness after the age of 40. So that's why I always tell people that life begins at 40. So if you are 50, you are only 10 years old. If you are 60, you are only 20 years old. If you die at 90 also, you are only 50 years old. So one of the great challenges of being a human being is never to get old in the mind and in the heart. Yes, the body has an age, but the whole idea is that you should not get old in the mind and the heart. So for that, you need a lot of hunger. And the third most important question, are you honest? You know, I may sell a policy today for my commission, but you may end up actually causing a lot of damage to the customer's requirements. And I always believe in the law of the karma. In the law of karma, what goes around will come around, and at some point it will catch up with you. I had an incident last week when one of my relatives called me and said I had taken a health policy from a company. That agent was my close friend, and now the company has denied me the mediclaim. And this person has threatened that close friend who is an agent that I will get you arrested for giving me wrong information. You know, and just selling me the policy because you wanted to make your commissions. I want all of you to remember these three questions before we get into the 10 power performance parameters. Ask yourself always, whenever you're doing something in life, first of all, am I happy? Am I hungry? And the third is, am I honest? T. Harv Eker says a very beautiful thing. Your income grows only to the extent that you do. A lot of people say, I'm not able to make a lot of money. But that's because you are not growing from within. So I think each one of you has spent money to be here for 3 days in this conference. You are really super awesome. You deserve a big round of applause and a pat on your back for yourself. Because there are thousands of people who could have been here today, but they have chosen not to be here. And many of them maybe have chosen because they didn't want to invest the money into learning. And you don't earn unless you learn, because the word earn is part of the word learn. There are some great secrets that I want to share about success. Like I said, success does not create happiness. Happiness creates success. Success is a journey, not a destination. And the most important thing is, you got to enjoy this journey. A lot of people ask me, you quit your job 7 years ago. How is it going? Are you making money? I said, I can't answer that question because money is a very private question. But I can tell you this much, that I've never lived my life like I've lived in the last 7 years. The opportunity to travel, to meet amazing people like you, the opportunity to get this kind of a platform. And I've earned this platform. If I was a vice president of my company, my boss would say, because you're vice president, you have to address an audience. But here I've been invited because people think I'm doing a good job. And you get your commission because people think you're doing a good job. And what you and me do every day is we are creating our own lives. And that's the most beautiful part about the journey of success. And one thing I realized about money, it's more beautiful when you create it rather than when somebody gives it to you. Yes or no? It's far more beautiful when you create it rather than somebody. So maybe in the job, I would have been earning lakhs of rupees. I would have been national training head, Asia Pacific training head, whatever. But even if I'm earning less than what I would have got in my salary, every rupee of this has been created by me. Every rupee that you earn has been created by you. It has not been given to you by anyone else. So it is more important to be sensitive than be successful. This is what I realized in life, in the journey of success. Everybody talks about success, success, success. MDRT, MDRT, COT, TOT. But it's more important to be sensitive. And how do you become sensitive is when you put the mission before the commission. And you will always see that people who earn a lot of commission and they are successful MDRTs, right from 2000 to 2007, when the economy was at its peak, they continued to be MDRT even after during the recession. That is only because they put the mission before the commission. And it's more important to be sensitive than be successful in life. And when I do sessions for school students, like sir was sharing in my introduction that I also do sessions for schools, I tell the students that there are 20 lakh children in our school, in our country today, who do not get basic primary education because they don't have the money, the parents don't have the money to send them to school. They have to work for earning a living. And each one of you who out here who's a student is so you should be so grateful, so fortunate that you're getting such amazing education. I go and talk to management students, and instead of learning, they're actually becoming more and more arrogant. And I always tell them that education is not about arrogance. Education is about humility. If education makes you arrogant, then that is not education. It is something else. That means your success is coming by trampling upon other people. But when your success comes through sensitivity, that means your success is coming because of the blessings of other people. And it is more important to get blessings than to get success. And the more blessings you get, the more success you will get. Right, so let's look at how you can change your game through the 10 power performance parameters by which you will be able to change your life. And the first performance parameter is purpose. Why do I go and sell and do what I do? Everybody knows what's the product, how to sell it, what to do, whom to meet. But I can show you a lot of agents who are very good at product knowledge, but they are sitting at home doing nothing. And I can, and they are the typical what we call in Mumbai Hindi as the 12 policy agent. You know, suddenly in December they will put 12 policies. I don't know what they were doing from January to November. So they know what to do, but they don't know why they have to do what they are doing. As somebody has said, the purpose of life is a life of purpose, and it is the 3L philosophy. The purpose of living is leaving a legacy. Living, leaving, and legacy. And one of the most beautiful things about your profession, your business, is that you can leave a legacy for many, many, many generations to come. But the only question is, why are you doing this? And like somebody taught us when we started our career in life insurance, is that, like, I met an agent a couple of days ago of a private life insurance company because I was speaking somewhere and that person came and spoke to me. And she said, I am so good, but I don't have the courage to go and ask. The problem is not that you don't have the skill. The problem is you don't know why you have to sell life insurance. And somebody has said, you will become a complete romantic of the life insurance industry the day you settle your first claim. Till then, probably nobody really understands the power of this amazing business that we have got into. So the first performance parameter, power performance parameter, is purpose. The second is passion. It is so important to be passionate in life. I hope you are taking notes. Unless you have a, what do you call, a Rajnikant kind of a brain which can process everything for the last 500 years of information. So I request all of you to please take some notes. Make a note of this 10 power performance parameters, because one, you will forget. Second, what I'm requesting is you got to be a giver in life, not a taker. The best way to imbibe this learning is to, after this conference, is to call up 5 people who did not come for this conference from your circle and tell them, I'm going to give you some free gyan on the 10 power performance parameters, take a paper and a pen and write it down and say, my first parameter is purpose. The second is passion. And you got to be passionate about your work, because if you are passionate about your work, you will never have to work any day. If you love what you do, you will never have to work forever in your life. I heard one actress at a book launch of one of my friends say last week, she said, they asked her, how do you work so hard? Don't you get tired? Don't you need a break? She said, I get a break when I go to work. And I get tired when I go for a holiday. You know, so that's how passionate you need to be about your work. And because if you love your work, nothing is more beautiful in this world. And I always tell people that when you love people, it increases your expenses. But when you love your work, it increases your income. So what do you want? You want to increase your expense? Or you want to increase your income? And the only secret to that formula is, love people less and love your work more. Because when you love your work more, you will not get upset by people's behaviors in this world. And people have various reasons to upset you. But if you love your work more than anything else in this world, you will enjoy it so much and you will be able to make an immense contribution to this world. The third is process. Let's spend some time understanding what I am talking about here. The first is purpose. Second is passion. Passion is nothing but energy. Dale Carnegie said, if you want to double your productivity, all you need to do is double your enthusiasm. So if you want to go from MDRT to COT, what do you need to do? You just need to double your enthusiasm with which you do your MDRT, and you will become a COT. You want to become a TOT, double your enthusiasm with which you were trying to become a COT, and you will become a TOT. Again, if you double, then MDRT body will create a new award for you. Right? So, what is the meaning of process? Now, most of us in our business are doing a lot of product selling. Am I right? We know the product inside out. Even the LIC actuary will not know the product as much as the agent knows. Sir, that was a joke. You can laugh. you become so serious. So I have met a lot of agents who ask me a lot of questions about the product, and I say, boss, that is an actuarial course. It takes 7 years to do that course, and it takes another 7 years to create these 7 products, and you are a school dropout and you are asking me such complicated questions. Your job is not to analyze the product. Your job is to sell the product. And every product is good. No product is bad. But today, in the VUCA world, as we started this discussion with, in the VUCA world today, it is not about the product. It's about the solution. People are looking for solutions. Because today, the biggest threat to your business is this comedian Kapil Sharma. You know why? Not because he does comedy. But because he is the brand ambassador for policybazaar.com. And every customer in this country has internet access. All they need to do is to know about any product. They need to go to the website of the company, or they need to go to the policybazaar.com, and they need to take out the product, and they know what the product is all about. If the agent is still going to continue to talk only about the product, you are not making any difference to the life of the customer. The most important, what Policy Bazaar cannot do for you is that the Policy Bazaar cannot design a solution for you. Policy Bazaar cannot design a solution for you. So do not do product selling, do solution selling. Never sell a policy without a proper fact finder. Never sell a policy without knowing whether the customer needs my services or not. And if you feel the customer does not require your services, have the courage to tell the customer, boss, you don't need my services. You can go somewhere else. You are adequately insured. Thank you very much. But please give me 5 references. The most important thing today is to do a professional selling process. Salespeople do not get the respect of customers mainly because they do not follow the process. So it's the way you conduct yourself. It's how you introduce your company. It's how well you're groomed, how you make a sales presentation, how you ask relevant questions. So the important thing to understand is sales is not just an art. It's actually a science. It's a skill. It is not a talent. It's a skill. And so whenever I'm called for sales motivation sessions, I tell people at the end of the session, the person who's going to benefit the most from this session is myself. Because what you require besides this, this is good, obviously this is useful, but what you require more than this is to have better skills. Objection handling skills, closing skills, HNI selling skills, NRI market selling skills. There are so many skill sets that we require to be a great sales professional. And you may be in the business for the last 10 years, 20 years, 25 years, 15 years. It doesn't matter. You can always keep upgrading your skill. And one of the great challenges that I find with people who do not survive very long in the agency business is they get very bored doing the same thing again and again. Every day you have to call, every day you have to book an appointment, every day you have to go and talk about the need, every day you have to go and sell the product, every day you have to ask for references, and once a year you have to come to LUGI. Right? So what is happening is people get bored. And if you ask me what is the biggest reason why agents don't survive, even successful agents don't survive beyond say 2 or 3 years, and you will see a lot of examples of people who leave the business even after 5 years because they get bored. But you know the secret to success in life? Successful people always do the things failures do not like to do. And successful people are in love with boredom. So what is called as insurance business is called as a magnificently boring profession. What is it called? It is called as a magnificently boring profession. And it is like a housewife. It is like a homemaker. It's like our mother. It is like our wife who for the last 40 years our mother can cook the same sambar, same aloo curry, same idli, same vada, same dosa, same upma for the same boring husband for 40 years without a single person drop in quality. And that is why you find in the insurance business, ladies are more successful than men. Why? Because they have the ability to do the same thing over and over again, with greater passion, with greater love. But men are always distracted. Before marriage also they were distracted. After marriage also they are distracted. But women realize one thing, all men are the same, it doesn't matter whom you marry. So all ladies, please clap for me. So follow a structured selling process. And what do I mean by a structured selling process is how you introduce yourself, how you introduce your company, and you need to learn these skills. How do you do a need analysis? And how do you actually handle objections? What's the principle behind objection handling? What are the 2 or 3 important principles in closing? But the most important thing is not the closing of the call. It is more important to care for the person for whom you are, with whom you are doing the call. You have to care for the customer. As somebody has said, if people do not know how much you care, it doesn't matter what you do. If people do not understand how much you care, it doesn't matter what you do. So the third P is process. I want to share 3 very important principles with all of you relating to process, which will change your life. First is, it is called as control the controllable. Now, have you heard agents come and say that I have been going on calls but it is not closing? So I don't feel motivated to go on a call. But what is most important to understand is, in the word agency, A-G-E-N-C-Y, A is for activity. The only thing I can control in my life is activity. The only thing I can control in a good marriage is my behavior, not my spouse's behavior. So it is called control the controllable. So if you want to be successful in the agency business, what is that you need to do? You need to go do what is in your control. Can you pick up the phone and call people? That's in your control. Can I go and meet people? That's in my control. Can I do a good sales presentation? That's in my control. Can I snatch the check from the customer? No. That is not in my control. So first is control the controllable. Second, I have a question for all of you. How many of you think becoming an MDRT is a great goal? It's a fantastic goal that I want to be MDRT, I want to be COT, I want to be TOT, I want to buy a new house in the next 1 year, 3-bedroom apartment at Edapalli, Kochi or Marine Drive. Is that a good goal? It is not a goal. That is the first problem. This is your desire. And for a number of years, different trainers and motivational speakers have been teaching you the wrong thing and telling you that wanting to become MDRT is a goal. I love somebody, we all love somebody in life, right? In college, school, and after marriage, obviously. To the person you married. Not outside. So I'm in love with a girl, I want to marry that girl. Is that a goal? That's a desire. Namba college la solluvom theriyuma, a fielding pannalam ba. Fielding. Cricket language. Namba fielding pannalam. Fielding pannalanaga, what does it mean? Beautiful girls will come out of the hostel and you will stand and watch. That is the meaning of fielding. Illa college la panni paathuten sir, onnu nadakkala. Now, if I want to marry a beautiful girl, or I want to marry somebody, that is my desire. What I do to ensure she marries me is my goal. So my activity is my goal. This can change your life, I'm telling you. So on a fielding padla, that's a goal. I can write a letter to her, that's a goal. I can make a friendship with her through a common friend. I can try for that. That can be a goal. I can go and tell her I love you. But when will the marriage happen? When she will say, okay, I also love you and I wish to marry you. Let us get married. That is not in my control. So if I want to become MDRT, how many calls I will do? How many people I will meet, my market segmentation, my strategy, all that is in my control. But whether the policy holder will buy the policy or not is not in my control. Even if I complete the criteria, whatever 8 lakh, 9 lakh commission, whatever it is, I complete the criteria, MDRT body says, yes, saal tumko certificate dene ka mood nahi hai. I don't feel like giving you the certificate. So getting the certificate is also not in your control. You can log in the policy. Whether the policy will get cleared or not is not in your control. So what is a goal? A goal is whatever is in your control. And what is in your control? Activity is in your control. Buying the house is not in your control. Getting the money is not in your control. And why a lot of agents fail is because they do not know the difference between a goal and a desire. And they always thought that the desire is the goal. The desire is not the goal. Like I'm doing this session. What's in my control? I can come well prepared. I can speak with energy. I can do my best. Whether you will clap for me or not is not in my control. But please do clap. So now my desire worked. Okay? And the third is inspect what you expect. So you expect that I should have earned 8 lakh commission to become COT by June itself. Are you measuring your progress? Suppose you say I am at 125 kg, I want to bring my weight down to 80 kg in the next 14 months, whatever that number is, or 100 kg. Are you inspecting what you are expecting? Are you standing on the weighing scale and saying, okay, am I down from 120 to 118 or I have gone up from 120 to 122? Especially when gulab jamun comes in front of you, it's very difficult to reduce it from 120 to 118. So inspect what you expect. So control the controllable. So never tell your children, get me 90%. Tell your children, do what it requires to get 90%. Ultimately, it is in the hand of the person who corrects the paper on that day. If it is a lady, she is upset with her husband, she'll take it out on your child. You cannot control other people's actions. That is why Mamiyar and Matupon, they fight all the time. Because Mamiyar is trying to control the Matupon and the Matupon is trying to control the Mamiyar. And in between, you and me are getting controlled by two different people. Fourth is persistence. I love this the most. Winners never quit. Quitters never win. Winners are not people who never fail, but they are people who never quit. One of the biggest reasons why agents fail is not because they don't earn enough money or they don't get policies. They fail because they run away. You can ask Arvind Mani, sir, how long did it take for me to come on the LUGI platform? Minimum 2 years, Arvind Mani, sir. 2 years to be here today. He kept trying, I kept trying, we kept irritating each other. If you would have met him 2 years ago, he had slightly more hair. He has got less hair because I plucked some of it through my persistence. Sir, when are you calling? When are you calling? When, he said, when are you coming? When are you coming? So what I'm saying is it requires a lot of passion and it requires a lot of persistence. It requires a lot of lot of effort to get your dreams to turn into reality. How many of you believe dreams come true? One more problem that motivational speakers have created in your life. I should have come into your life before. I'm just trying to market myself. All respect to all motivational speakers. I'm just joking. Dreams never come true. You have to make them come true. Dreams never come true. And dreams are not those dreams which you see in the night when you're sleeping. Dreams are really those things which don't allow you to sleep. That is a real dream. And if you are restless and you want to achieve, you have not reached your target and you are restless, that's a good thing. As long as you are not complaining. And you are working towards it. So I want to show you an amazing video of a gentleman who became one of the greatest legends in cricket through sheer persistence. And his name is not Sachin Tendulkar. He is not Sachin Tendulkar. I am referring to somebody else. So let's watch this video. I'm going to start again. Please watch every slide of this, and it's really inspiring. What an absolutely amazing guy. It took 6 years for Marwan Attapattu to score his second run in Test match cricket. How many cricketers do you think would have been still playing cricket? I know agents who became MDRT for the first time after 5 years. I know agents who became MDRT in the first month and never sold another policy for the rest of their life. It's not about how good you are. Everybody is good in his or her own way. It's about how persistent you are. And your persistence will come only if your purpose is strong. There's a great example of Shammi Kapoor, who flopped in 19 of his films before his 20th film, which was Tumsa Nahi Dekha, became a super hit, and he went on to become one of Bollywood's greatest superstars. And as he kept failing, he told his wife, I want to give up everything and I want to go and join some tea estate in Ooty or somewhere and give up all this. The problem with human beings is not that they can't succeed, but the problem is they can't handle failure. And this is what we need to teach our children also. This is what we need to teach entrepreneurs. This is what we need to teach the country. Kapil Dev picked up 434 wickets to become the number one bowler in the world. For that, he delivered 14,000 deliveries in his career. And he failed 13,600 odd times to pick up a wicket. He did not become the world's number one bowler because he took 434 wickets, but because he delivered 14,000 deliveries. People don't become a centurion with 100 policies in a year because they sold 100 policies, but that's because they approached 500 people and called up 1,500 of them out of that for 1,500 to book an appointment. And the best breaking news is, the more you fail, the bigger will be your success. And the faster you become successful, you are likely to be a long-term failure. If you are not sensible enough. So, the power of failure is very, very critical. Fifth is pain. How many of you want to lead a comfortable life? How many of you want to lead a successful life? That's a problem, right? Can you be comfortable and be successful? No person in this world can ever become successful by being comfortable. You are learning today since morning and you learn for the next 2 days. It's very uncomfortable, right? You feel like speaking, but you cannot because the speaker is speaking. I can say two more things, you know. Everybody is a trainer in our country. You have to sit through long hours to learn 10 new things in your life. It's not easy. Sachin Tendulkar used to practice 15 hours, 10 hours. That's why he became Tendulkar. Amitabh Bachchan at the age of 75. He is working for 15 hours a day. That's not comfort. That discomfort is creating that great success. So do you have the ability to handle pain? Because only pain produces performance. Athletes practice for 15 years to win a gold medal, and the difference between the gold and silver is only 15 seconds. And to achieve that 15 seconds extra, they work for and practice for 15 years. So this is the iceberg theory. People only look at the success above, but they don't look at the challenges and the pain that you went through in your life. Sixth is people. It's all about building relationships. It's not about selling. It's about building a Relationship. It's about creating the trust. It's about loving the customer and taking care of his or her needs. It's not about your commission. It's always the mission before the commission. Seventh is about professionalism. How professional are we in our life? How are we dressed? How do we present yourself? I know that a lot of you might be great, very successful agent, and for years to come you will remain successful, but you may also want to change the way you work and become more professional, become more solution oriented rather than product oriented. One of the great things about private insurance companies is they're a little bit more professional, and that's creating the competition, which is a good thing for all of us, and we can learn from them. Eighth is predictability. Like Virat Kohli. I know that if Virat Kohli goes to bat, there is every chance that he will at least score a half century. Are you a predictable performer? That the new year has started, I know that this gentleman is going to be an MDRT. This lady is going to be an MDRT because of that person's work ethic. It's the ability of that person to work in a particular way, work professionally, and work with passion and commitment. Ninth is work for your potential. Never work for money. Always work for potential. I always tell people, don't make money the reason for your work. Make money the result of your work. Never make money the reason for your work. Make money the result of your work. Work for your potential. What's your potential? We saw the first video, right? You're awesome. Man can do anything, provided he prepares, he practices, he puts in that effort, he handles that pain, he's persistent, never gives up. Your potential is not MDRT. That's a milestone. Your potential is not COT. That's a milestone. Your potential is not TOT. That's a milestone. Your potential is something which people have never dreamt of. That's your potential. My potential is not just addressing this conference. My potential is a stadium. That's my dream. One day I should be addressing in a stadium with 1 lakh people sitting in front of me. My dream is to be at the Wembley Stadium. My dream is to be the Melbourne Cricket Ground giving a speech. What's there to dream free? Modi cannot come and tell you tomorrow, from tomorrow your dreams are invalid. Only your 500 rupee notes and 1000 rupee notes can become invalid. Your dreams never become invalid. And the bigger you dream, you become more excited in life. Excited people produce exciting results. Excited people produce exciting results. Boring people produce boring results. Sometimes the customer actually feels like dying after meeting the agent. He feels so bored. So it's very important to understand that work for your potential. Keep raising the bar. Keep raising the bar. Keep raising the bar. When Tendulkar scored 18 one-day centuries, that was a world record. He broke Desmond Haynes' record. It was 17 one-day centuries. That was a world record. Tendulkar ended at 49 one-day centuries. He could have retired at the end of 18 one-day hundreds. But look at that man's potential. He went to 100 international centuries. And everybody thought nobody can reach there. But the way Kohli is playing, look at the guy's hunger. You never know where he will end up by the time he finishes. And in our time, we thought there is nobody bigger than Gavaskar. Gavaskar looks like a very small performer now. But that's the power of human ability, human nature. We can always beat the last record, create a new record, and somebody else will come and break another record. There is a pole vaulter called Sergi Bubka. He used to break his own record in every Olympic. He was competing with himself. And the last is performance orientation. I can do all the 9 P's. I will have purpose, I will have persistence, I can handle pain, I can handle failure, but I don't believe in performance. You must have result orientation. Finally, you work for what? You work for the output. You work for the performance. You should have ownership towards that performance. To take a cricketing analogy here, a batsman may have a great technique, but can he play the game unless he scores runs? Can he play the game unless he scores runs? Similarly, just going on a call, you will not make commission. You must have the orientation to get the business. It will not happen each time, but you must have that orientation within you. Because you must understand, you don't get paid for hard work, you only get paid for performance, but there is never any performance without hard work. And today's new agents, they don't want to work hard. They just want to come and say, I am such a handsome person, look at me, buy a policy. They don't want people to tell them no. As if they signed one contract with God that I will become an agent and nobody will tell me no. Younger generation doesn't want to work hard. Parents don't want to work hard giving the right values. Today if you ask me, the biggest value in the world is hard work. If people will understand this, that's good enough. Got to work hard. If you don't work hard, how will you achieve your results? So the part of result orientation and performance orientation comes from our ability to work hard. Every day, get up in the morning. I'm giving you a simple 2x2 formula, which will be useful in your business, which you're probably already doing, but you can pass it on to other people. You must do 2 calls every day. 2 new people you should meet every day and collect at least 2 new references every day.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you so much.
We could see the power of your sound, power of your language, power of your subject, and power of P. Thank you very much. Now may I call upon Mr. A. Ramalingam P. Velur, Salem, to present a memento to Shri.Hariharan Iyer.